and it states that regardless of the multiple steps of the reaction, the total enthalpy of a reaction is just the sum of all the changes. And enthalpy is a state function, which means it doesn't matter the path that it takes. It just matters on the final destination.
Okay. Here's an example of modifying enthalpies of reaction. So this first reaction here, we have two reactants go to one product with an enthalpy of X. However, if we switch this reaction and have our product become a reactant, our enthalpy now has to be flipped, meaning it has to be negative. In a similar situation, instead of flipping the reaction, we can multiply everything by a coefficient of 2, or we can substitute this for anything else, as long as we change our reaction enthalpy to match that. So if we multiply by 2, our enthalpy has to be multiplied by 2 as well.
Melis!
Jenny's gonna be so disappointed in you. You missed lecture today.
How can I make it up to her?
You know what you can do? You can make me and Jenny a smoothie!
I can make Jenny a smoothie!
Chemistry.
So in making our smoothie, we had the first step where we took the washed fruit and we turned it into peeled fruit. And then the peeled fruit, we turned into cut up fruit. And lastly, the cut up fruit was turned into our final product of the smoothie, using the blender. Now, if we look at our final equation, we just have the washed fruit turning into the smoothie. And that's because we have things called intermediates in these steps. So, when you look at the final equation, you have peeled fruit, but then it's just turned into a reactant in the next step. So you can take it out of the final equation. You also have cut up fruit, which is used as a reactant in the last step. So you can take that out of the final equation as well. Then you're just left with washed fruit turning into the smoothie at the very end. Now, each of these steps has an enthalpy of reaction. And when you're looking at the total enthalpy, just like how you added these steps, you can also add the individual enthalpies to get the enthalpy of the total reaction.
Just gonna give this smoothie to my favorite TA, Jenny.
Scott!
So we need double the amount of starting fruit to get double the amount of peeled fruit. And then when you have double the amount of peeled fruit, you can have double the amount of cut up fruit. And then double the amount of cut up fruit gets you double the amount of smoothie, which is what we want in the end. Now, when reaction, multiplying it by a coefficient, you also have to multiply by the same coefficient with the enthalpy. So you'll have 2 delta H of peeling the fruit, 2 delta H of cutting up the fruit, and 2 delta H of blending the fruit. And your total delta H for making 2 smoothies will be twice that of making 1 smoothie.
Done.